Hi students, now you are watching 7th class mathematics 3rd unit exercise 3.2. The exercise 3.2 mainly deals with the multiplication of decimal numbers. How to do the multiplication? We already know how to do the multiplication for the whole numbers. Let us see how the multiplication varies from whole numbers to decimal numbers. For example, I have a number like 2.145. Okay. Now, I am going to multiply 2.145 into 10. So, how to do this first? 2145 and make it as a fraction, 1000, because three numbers after dot into 10. 10 cancel with 10, only 10. Okay. Now, how many zeros are there in down? 2 zeros. So, it will become 21.45. In the same way, 2.145 is multiplying with 100. 2145 by 1000 into 100. Now, 2 zeros will get cancelled. Now, down only 10. In the denominator, there is only 10. So, it will become 214.5. Now, 2.145 into 1000. It means 2145 by 1000 into 1000. 1000 cancel. The value will be 2145. So, 2.145. When it is multiplying with 10, it's becoming 21.45. When it is multiplying with 100, it's becoming 214.5. And when multiplying with 1000, it became 2145. So, the number of zeros is going to add that many number of positions, the dot is moving to the right side. 2 becomes 21 when you multiply with 10. 2 becomes 100 when you multiply with 100. 2 becomes 2000 when you multiply with 1000. It's based on the point value, based on the point position. When you multiply with some 100,000 like that, it will move one bit. Okay, understand children? For example, so you understand how to multiply a decimal number with 100,000, something like that. But when it comes to normal numbers, like for example, I have 0.3 into 0.4. Okay, how to multiply these? Make it as 3 by 10 into 4 by 10. Numerators you can multiply. In the same way, denominators you can multiply. 3 4s are 12 divided by 10 into 10, 100. So, 2 zeros. So, it will become 0.12. It becomes 0.12 because two numbers before dot. Same way, 0.75 into 1.2. Okay, 75 by 100 into 12 by 10 into 12 by 10. So, 75 into 12. 5 2s are 10. 7 2s are 14. 14 plus 1, 15. 1 5s are 5. 1 7s are 7. 0. 5 plus 5, 10. 1 plus 7, 8. 8 plus 1, 9. 900. 900 divided by 100 into 10, 1000. Okay. So, 3 digits. 0.900. After point, if you have zeros before any number, for example, see, you no need to write these zeros because there is no number after this. 0.900, 0.900 is equals to 0.9. If it is 0.009, you should not cancel this. You have to write like this only. For example, if you have 0.800540, you can rewrite this number as 0.80005. You can remove these numbers. How many zeros are there at the last? You don't need to consider. For example, in the previous exercise also, you saw 50 pies, how they used to mention 0.5 pies. Right? If it is a 5 pies, how we are mentioning 0.05. 0.05 is a 5 pies. And this is 50 pies. Like that we mention only, no? In the previous exercise, in the same way. Understand, children? How to do multiplication? And for example, you can also calculate the same thing in a different way. (1.2 × 0.3). Okay. Instead of doing 12/10 × 3/10, you can also calculate in a different way. Like, consider it as a 12 and consider it as a 3. 3 2s are 6, 3 1s are 3. 36. Right? 36. And where you have to put the dot? After dot, how many numbers are there? How many digits? Only one. Here, how many? Only one. 1 plus 1, 2. Understand? I'll explain one more example for that. 37.5 × 1.96. See, here it is two digits numbers. 12 threes are 36. Easily you can write. But when it comes to the matter of three digits, we cannot multiply 375 × 196. No. So what you have to do? You just multiply 375 with 196. 6 5s are 30. 7 6s are 42. 42 plus 3, 45. Right? Next. 6 3s are 18. 18 plus 4, 22. Next. 9 5s are 45. 9 7s are 63. 63 plus 4, 67. Next. 9 3s are 27. 27 plus 6, 33. Understand? Now, 1 5s are 5. 1 7s are 7. 1 3s are 3. 0. 5 plus 5, 10. 2 plus 7, 9. 9 plus 5, 14. 14 plus 1, 15. 2 plus 3, 5, 5 plus 7, 12, 12 plus 1, 13, 3 plus 3, 6, 6 plus 1, 7, 7. Now, point after, here one digit is there. Here point after, two digits are there. 1 plus 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So you have to place the point here. And I already told, after point, if there are n number of zeros are there, you can cancel it. So the answer of 37.5 × 1.96 is 73.5. Understand? Okay, let us move to the exercise 3.2. Find the product. So simple questions, no? Simple two digit numbers. (0.36) 0.3 × 6 means 3/10 × 6. 18. Only one. So place it here. 1.8. The answer is 1.8. Next. Same way, I am going to explain F. 4 into 1.44 means 4 into 144 divided by 100. Okay. 576 by 100. 144 into 4, 576. So, 2 zeros no, 5.76. Okay, do the remaining all problems in the maths HW. Okay, do it in the maths HW. Next, second one, find the product. Here, all the numbers are tens, hundreds, thousands, like that. And I already explained here. How the point position will change when we are multiplying with the tens, hundreds, thousands. Here also same question. So, you can do it by your own, but still I will explain just one or two problems. 2.4 into 10 means, 10 means one digit, 24 point. No need to keep the point because there is no numbers after that. Next, B. 2.45 into 10. So, 24, one point is moving right hand side. 0.5. Here, there is no other number. So, we no need to keep anything. But here, 5 is there. That is the reason we kept 0.5 here. Same way. I am going to explain L. 0.512 into 100. Two numbers means 51.2. Like that, do the remaining things in the maths HW. Here, this is something like second one only. Here, they multiplied with tens, hundreds and thousands and they are asking us the answer. But here, by multiplying with number, we are going to get these answers. That is, they are asking. Okay? Now, the point is moving only one step right side. Means we have to multiply with 10. Here, 1 point. Only 1 point moved. So again, here also 10. Here, same 10. 10. But here, 2 steps. So, 100. And here, point moved to 1, 2, 3 steps. There is nothing after here. Means 1000. Like this you have to write in the maths HW. Not in the CW. Okay, don't write in the textbook. Next, find the product. Find the product. So, here also they give find the product. And here also they give find the product. See, we already done in this way. We already done by taking point as a zero, by taking point as a zero to the denominator. So we already used this method. And here you have to multiply both the numbers and arrange the point according to the answer. A 3.4 into 0.2. It means 34 into 2. 4 2s are 8. 3 2s are 6. So answer is after point here 1, here also 1. So 0.68 is the answer. In the same way, you have to do each and every one, and I am going to explain the last one. Z 0.202 into 220.1. So 202 into 2201. Okay. 1 2s, 1 0s, 1 2s, 0 0 0, 2 2s are 4, 0 2 2s are 4, again 2 2s are 4, 0 2 2s are 4, 2 0 6 4 4 4. Now how many point in which place we have to keep the point? Here how many digits are there after point? 3. And here how many digits are there after point? 1. 3 plus 1 4. 1 2 3 4. It means 44.4602. 44.4602, that is the answer. Understand children? Simple, no? Fifth one. The length of a rectangle is 9.2 cm and its breadth is 6 cm. Find the area of the rectangle. We know the formula, right? Okay. Please copy the complete question all the time. Length of a rectangle is equals to 9.2 cm. Breadth of a rectangle is equals to 6 cm. Therefore, area of a rectangle is equals to L into B, 9.2 into 6. Okay, so 92 into 6, 6 2s are 12, 6 9s are 54, plus 1 55, 5 52. Only one point here, there is no point here, so only one digit after point, 55.2 square centimeter. Understand? Now, sixth one. The length of a one side of a regular pentagon is 14.7 cm. Find its perimeter. So pentagon means how many sides it will be having? Pentagon means it will be having 5 sides like this. Okay, so and all the sides are equal. Here it is 4 means 4, 4, 4, 4. Perimeter means 5 4s are 20. So, same way. Length of a pentagon is equals to 14.7 cm. Perimeter. Perimeter of a pentagon is equals to 5 into L, means 5 into 14.7. It means 147 into 5. 7 3s are 35. 5 4s are 20. Plus 3, 23. 5 1s are 5. 7. So, 7 3 5. Point after only one digit. So 73.5 cm. Understand? Understand how to multiply two decimal numbers? The remaining all problems are multiplication of two numbers. See, a bag has 10 kg potatoes. If the cost of 1 kg is 16.75, find the cost of one bag of potatoes. One bag of potatoes is having 10 kgs. So, obviously we have to find the value for 10 kg potatoes. 16.75 into 10. How much it will become? 167.5. And all the questions are just multiplication problems only. So, do all these questions, solve all these questions in Maths HW. Bye for now.